in the quarterfinals. This is the FIBA Basketball World Cup 2019. Yes, we are live from the Shenzhen-based Sports Center on the southeast coast of China. A very warm welcome from myself, Tim Long, alongside FIBA Hall of Famer Andrew Gaze. Some fantastic first round action on this court, but now we turn it up a notch. The first game of the second round, and there is no room for error for the Czech Republic against a Brazilian team to become the fifth entrant into the quarterfinals bracket.
Spot on, Tim, and both these teams have been very, very good to qualify for this stage, as you have to be in a quality field, and the Czech Republic in particular, I love the way they've gone about it. They've had their fair share of luck, which both teams, you need your fair share of luck to get this far, but this is going to be a great battle between two teams that I see fairly evenly matched.
This is an historic tournament for the Czech Republic, their first ever World Cup, having failed to qualify from each of the previous six editions. Since the dissolution of Czechoslovakia, their biggest achievement is finishing seventh at Eurobasket 2015. They will be one of the co-hosts for Eurobasket 2021. Several group games in Prague, and this program very much moving in the right direction.
Oh, spot on, and they've got players now playing all over the world. Six players from the one team from the Czech Republic playing in this team. That helps the camaraderie, it also helps with the cohesion, and it's been on show here throughout the tournament.
Brazil are two-time world champions, winning the World Cup back in 1959 and 1963, also losing finalists in 54 and 1970. They're the only nation besides the USA to appear in every edition since the very first tournament back in 1950. Bronze medals in 67 and 78 as well. They were sixth at the last edition in 2014, and this team unbeaten so far here in 2019.
It certainly is, it does, and a really good blend between experience, and when I say experience, I'm talking real experience. Three players have played in five World Cups, so they've got a lot to offer some of the younger players coming through the ranks, and how good have the Americas been? The America Zone have been fantastic throughout this tournament, and Brazil, one of the teams that really can go all the way, and we didn't predict that before the start of the tournament.
This is the first game of Group K, the second round in around 4 hours' time, and is the biggest box office battle of the World Cup so far. Shenzhen crackling with anticipation already for Greece against the USA. Records carrying through from the first round. A win here would see Brazil through. A defeat for Czech Republic would see them on the brink of elimination. They'd be left needing to beat Greece and needing the USA to lose both tonight and tomorrow. And even then, they'd need to advance from a three-way tie. Let's pause now for the two national anthems.
Of Czech Republic. 女士们、先生们，请全体起立，演奏双方运动队国歌。首先演奏捷克共和国国歌。 And now, the national anthem of Brazil. 下面演奏巴西国歌。
We're all set for the opening match of Group K here in the second round of the 2019 FIBA World Cup. Business is picking up in Shenzhen. Two-time champions Brazil looking for a win that would book their place in the quarterfinals. The Czech Republic in their very first World Cup appearance looking for a win that would keep their hopes alive.
They are, and Brazil with that spectacular landmark win they had over Greece. So they come into this series holding most of the cards. Their fate is more in their hands than it is with the Czech Republic. But this Czech Republic team, they've got a lot of depth. They use a lot of players. And the thing that sticks out the most is we take a look at the officials for today's game. But with this Czech Republic team, very unselfish. They're prepared to share the ball around. And I think that helps with having those players all playing for the one club team back in the Czech Republic.
They are without superstar centre Jan Veselý due to injury, but half of this team playing with the dominant Czech champions Nymburk, who've won the title in each of the last 16 seasons. Hruban and Balvin shot a joint tournament fourth best, 68.4% on the inside in round one. Bohatchik was one of the top scorers, averaging 16.7 points in that first stage.
It is, and they've got a whole bunch of talent on their team, but it's that man, Tomasz Satoranski, that has really been the glue to all this. He's averaging 14 points a game, 6 assists and the 5 rebounds. A little down on his field goal percentages though, only shooting at 38% from the field, but that really hasn't been that relevant because of the attention that he draws and the way in which he gets others involved.
Brazil have a squad of wily veterans with a sprinkle of youthful exuberance. 2015 NBA champion Leandro Barbosa joining the likes of Anderson Varejão, and two current NBAers as well in Cristiano Felicio and Bruno Caboclo, having all been big on the boards, and Marcelino Huertas and Rafa Luz, each averaging 4.3 assists per game.
Yeah, super experienced group this has coming together, and they've needed every ounce of it to help not only get the wins but educate some of the young fellas. And when you speak of veterans, it doesn't get much better than Anderson Varejão, who he's played in the NBA or had played in the NBA for 13 seasons in this tournament, putting up some very respectable numbers as well, 11-7. And he's another one that's going to be drawn upon tonight. And a real big assignment that he's got with Balvin down the other end of the floor.
The Czechs started with a 21-point defeat against the USA, but they were competitive in three of the four quarters, losing the first and the fourth by just 3 and the third by just 4. Then came a 13-point win over Japan before stunning a very talented Turkey team by 15 in an all-or-nothing third game. The fourth most accurate three-point shooting team in the whole of the first round at 43.3%. And they protected the ball well too. A tournament fifth best, 10 turnovers per game in round one.
And to number 50, active ends all the time, okay? Best position, be down for you, okay? Entre vosotros dos, a principio cuando podemos ser, y Victor 16. En caso contrario, cuentan con los suyos. Sexy, dice yo, ¿ah? Sí. Pero comenzamos con puño y con tiro arriba. Atacamos a Bandina principio. Ojo a zona 2-3. Poste alto. Fuera contra la zona. 1-2-1-1. Meter balón dentro. Todo. No subir antes que llevar la bola. Chao, rebote. Atrás, correr atrás.
Under Alexander Petrovic, Brazil arrive here a perfect 3-0. They poured in 102 points to down New Zealand by 8 in their opener. Then a huge 1-point win over Greece in game 2. Sloukas missing a foul shot that would have tied the score with 2 seconds to play. And then came an 11-point win over Montenegro on Thursday. A very solid team in all areas. The joint third best at protecting the ball, just 9.3 turnovers per game in the first stage. The fifth best at the foul line at 81.3%. The seventh most rebounds and assists in round one.
It is, and that win over Greece was not without some fanfare as well, with Gigi Luzada with the foul and the three-pointer almost cost his team. Well, certainly would have gone in an overtime, but they got out of jail and a quality win. And very hard to split these two teams and predict the winner.
Brazil have consistently moved the ball well, over 20 assists in each of the three games. Czech Republic shooting it well from long range. Only three teams have hit a higher percentage from the outside. For these teams, a new city, a new venue, new opponents and a new goal. The hurdle of the first round complete. Attention turns to sealing a place in the quarterfinals of the FIBA Basketball World Cup. Brazil get there with a win. Czech Republic most likely need to win to keep their chances alive. And they have the ball first. Looking for the first score of this first game here in the second round. Balvin with the long two.
Barajal helping out. That's the odds you take. You kind of have to live with something. He's been very good from the field. And that time they pay the penalty with trying to help down the low block.
Here goes Hafalu, looking to slice past Balvin, who's doing it at both ends of the floor already.
That was the start. You're right, the rim protection. On ball, pick and roll defense is so vital in the modern game, and how you're dealing with that, the decisions you've got to make, the strategy you imply.
Hafalu is looking to work with Varejão, goes alone and gets the floater to fall.
And there you see the other example of the on-ball defense. When the penetration can get that deep and you're just relying on the bigs to protect the rim, when you're crafty, it doesn't always work out.
Sadaransky back out, Balvin across. Here is Sadaransky on the outside, and he got hit on his route to the rim.
Although he's shooting from the field, it's not where he'd like, but he's a quality perimeter shooter. He's averaged 40% from the three-point line throughout his NBA career, and that's a touch further than what the three-point line is here. So they're going to get respect despite only the 38% from the field so far in the tournament.
The voice of FIBA Hall of Famer Andrew Gaze alongside myself, Tim Long, here with you in Shenzhen for the second round. And Czech Republic back up by two.
They've done this a bit throughout the tournament. A little token full court zone pressure just to try and be disruptive, take some time off the clock and get the opponents out of rhythm in the half court.
Hafalu's good luck for three. Can't hit. Rebound and a chance to run for Czech Republic. Sadaransky, what a lovely bounce pass, and Kruben on the cut to the basket provides the finish.
And that's what he does, he sees the floor. It's not just about himself, he gets others involved, and that's why he's gained the respect throughout this tournament as one of the marquee players.
Lose across to the far side towards the 39-year-old Alex. Ball out of bounds, still Brazil possession.
Have a look at the pass, the vision threads the needle, it's beautifully executed.
Lose. Caboclo looking to pirouette through the paint. Lovely move as he puts the defense in the spin cycle.
Very agile, the way he just used the drop step. The big fella creating off the bounce.
Had a breakout campaign in the NBA with the Grizzlies last season. Bruno Caboclo, 23 years of age. Here's Sadaransky. Hands it off far side, long-range two-pointer will go for Jaromir Bohacic, who continues his fine shooting form.
Well, this is an absolutely perfect start for the Czech Republic. Perfect 3 of 3 from the field. They're on fire.
Bohacic 58% inside, 44% from downtown in the first round. En route to 16.7 points. Brazil trying to stay with Czech Republic here. That one off the mark from Benic. Sadaransky waiting for Balvin, who was slightly behind the play. Bounce pass through a gap and put in. And they're scoring at will early on.
It really is a thing of beauty so far with the Czech Republic, and making the Brazilian defense almost look inept.
Alex. On to Varejão. 36 years of age, the center now looking to go to work on Balvin. Steps through the paint. Tough shot, wouldn't go. Balvin releases Sadaransky. Sadaransky shooting over the top of the defense, missing. Varejão the rebound. Alex, very fast-paced start here. Opening 3.5 minutes. Around the screen of Varejão to the far side. Lose with a good look again, misses.
In contrast, Brazil had some good looks, just missed some shots you'd normally expect them to make. 2 of 7. So a slow start to them.
Bohacic was toying with Caboclo. They move it around the perimeter to the far side. Three-pointer for Kruban off the mark. Lose to Alex. They're going to go to work here on Bohacic. Through the paint, the 39-year-old still got some moves.
He has the little nuggety down low post move. As you'd expect, no help coming. Just playing it straight one-on-one and good enough to take advantage of it.
A nine-time Brazilian All-Star and former league MVP. Two-time MVP in the Americas League Grand Finals. There's Krish losing it. Able to recover. Bohacic from deep at the buzzer. Rebound Caboclo. Brazil down by four. Alex.
Why not?
Wants to go again up against Bohacic. Waits for the help defense. Back to lose. And then Varejao for three. Wouldn't go.
I like the idea. Milk it. Found a formula down low with Alex. Might as well go back. That time they send a little bit of help.
Sadaransky to Balvin, lost it as he tried to spin towards the hoop, and an unsportsmanlike has been called.
No, I don't think it is.
Michel hits the deck, no.
Just a regular.
But the coach is asking for one.
He absolutely would, but that's just an unfortunate clipping of the legs. And as this rule has evolved, when it was first introduced, that was likely going to end up two and possession. But I think that's the right decision because an inadvertent clipping. There was no intent to stop that transition.
Yeah, you're right. I looked across and saw Petrovic.
Yeah, he's trying to make
him really wanted it. 3-point shot for Bernic. He's really struggled to shoot the ball so far. He was just 4 of 19 in the first round. Balvin onto Bohacic. Running interference. The big man on the outside. Bohacic trying to work with it. Balvin gets up against Alex on the inside. The ball doesn't come his way, though. Open look from the far side doesn't go down for Krish. Going all the way through, coast to coast on the dribble, was half a lose, but couldn't provide the finish.
He's not shy, is he, for a guy who's not shooting the ball, still out there trying to create for himself. That time a good penetration, just couldn't finish it around the basket.
Truban, Satoransky. Balvin on the outside again, looking to move into the paint. Sadaransky, another lovely bounce pass, and on the baseline cut, it's flicked up and in by Krish.
Fun to play with, wouldn't he? The way in which if you get open and he's got the ball, he will find you. And you can't say about that about some of the better players in the world, but it's a great delight to have someone who can distribute the ball like that on your team.
Sadaransky averaged 5 assists per game in the NBA with the Wizards last season. Brazil needed that one to halve the deficit, having gone behind by 6, and again it's Alex. The first three-pointer in this one on the 8th attempt. Sadaransky, free passage through the paint, but he ran into Bruno Caboclo, putting up the Great Wall here in China.
And Sadaransky, a little bit of payback, got his penetration thrown out, but does one better and picks up the three-pointer.
Here's Alex. He's absolutely full of it early on. Czech Republic back up by 6 after that shot from Sadaransky. But before that, how about the block from Caboclo?
It is. You see the foul down the other end. And here it is. He says, don't bring that soft stuff in. He says, all right, I'll go out and I'll knock down the trifecta.
Garcia at the line here for Brazil, looking to add to his 5 points already.
Ooh. Gee, has the little conniption halfway through the free throw shooting technique right here.
12.7 points, 3.7 assists, 1.3 steals per game in the first round for Alex.
Ooh. Not textbook, but effective.
7 points. Yet to miss a shot. 2 of 2 from the field, 2 of 2 from the line. Alder is in the game, wearing the number one. Here's Bohacic to the far side. Alder passing to Balvin. Little hesitation through the contact with Varejao up in the air. And a chance at a three-point play.
Just the ball movement is making Brazil reactive on every pass. They're playing catch-up because the speed in which the ball is moved around the perimeter and then the penetration with the pass as well as the dribble. They've got a nice little balance going on right now between the inside-outside and also the penetration with the pass and the dribble. This is really good execution by the Czech Republic.
Balvin's career really on an upward trajectory. All Euro Cup second team with Gran Canaria 2 years ago, and then an efficient 6.6 points, 5 rebounds in 18 and a half minutes per game in the EuroLeague last season, shooting 64% from the field. He'll play with Spanish side Bilbao this season. Varejao floating over the top of Balvin.
They broke that three-quarter court, 1-2-2 press with ease, and that'll get you thinking about trying that again when it's so easy.
Balvin just lost it that time as Sadoransky fired it into him. Here comes Marcelino Huertas. And they're forced to slow it down slightly. Alex crowded out in the paint. And they come up with the steal. Sadoransky on the burst. And a double dribble call.
Alex just flinging his arms around as he attempted that last field goal attempt, and he's cracked Balvin in the head. Let's see if we can have a look. Just a little elbow. There it is right there. Nothing too serious, you wouldn't think, but it certainly stung the big fella. You know what it's like when you get that on the nose, your eyes start watering. So I don't think he's too serious though, so good news.
Balvin will go to the bench. Martin Paterka comes in, 24-year-old centre, who played in the Basketball Champions League with Nymburk last season. Averaged 8.5 points, 4.5 rebounds. Varejao, Caboclo, Marcelino Huertas, Leandro Barbosa. Barbosa onto Varejao. Barbosa shooting in the corner, the two men who have NBA championship rings combining. Sadoransky. Blake Schilb is a real threat from the outside. Looking to go to work here. Up against Caboclo. Passes off the responsibility of the outside shot to Bohacic, who missed it. Huertas. Averaging 4.3 assists per game, only 0.7 turnovers. Alex running into Bohacic, forced back out. Plenty of time to work with still. Varejao up and under, wouldn't go down. Look at the rebound from Marcelino Huertas. And it leads to the three-point shot for Leandro Barbosa. A timeout called. The offensive rebound from the 1.9-meter Marcelino Huertas led to the Brazilian three for Barbosa. And they have closed the gap down to two.
Yeah, you see the difference with Paterka in the lineup. Doesn't quite have the same size, so they go downstairs to Varejao. Even though he missed it, he still was able to get the rebound, kick it out, opens up a three-point field goal. Ginsburg there, he's done an outstanding job with this team. You can just see the way they execute in the half court and how they play for each other. You've got to give a lot of credit, or significant portion of the credit, to the way the game plan is put in place, the execution and the culture you build within a group. He's done a terrific job with this Czech Republic team. Straight away, you see Balvin come back in.
Balvin and Sadoransky each with 5 to lead Czech Republic. Seven for Alex for Brazil to lead them. Final minute of the first quarter coming up here. There goes Saleransky again, floating one from in the middle. Got it to fall, he's now got seven.
That is great touch coming in. He made a little push shot look a whole lot easier than it actually was. That's not an easier shot to execute.
He's got three assists as well already here in the first quarter. Turnaround three, Leandro Barbosa hit one before the timeout but can't hit one afterwards. Saturansky, everything going through him as he hands it off on the perimeter here to Bohatchik. Blake Schill, Patrick Huber, both involved. Balvin setting the screen on the perimeter. Balvin will take on another long two. Misses that one. The tip from Saturansky and the rebound grabbed by Felicio.
You look at the way Brazil are playing Balvin. It's like they're willing to concede that mid-range jump shot. Just keep him away from the rim. Concede the mid-ranger. Uh-oh.
Oh, what about the pass from Huertas? But Felicio couldn't put the exclamation mark on it. And that will do it for the end of the first. It very nearly ended with a bang. Brazil leads, or Czech Republic lead rather, Brazil by 4 points, 20-16 at the end of one.
Yeah, but it's quite only trailing by four. I think that
you go for right. You and you take control on the court. We play now five, right?
That time there, interesting that they want to get Anders Varage out in as many on-balls they can. They want him, whoever he's defending, to come to set the on-ball screen, and they feel like they can attack him a little better. But great half by the Czech Republic. Anytime you're shooting it above 50%, they're 53%, 8 of 15. Brazil will be looking at the numbers and saying, well, hang on, we've only shot it at 33%, 29% from the three-point line, and we only trail it by four. So they would still be feeling pretty good about themselves in this one, despite the Czech Republic being very, very impressive.
Czech Republic only 1 of 5 from the outside, where we know they shoot the ball ever so well. They're 7 of 10 for 70% on the inside against the likes of Caboclo, Varejão and Felicio. There you can see, you can get your hands on the Basketball World Cup app. All of the scores, plenty of videos and information on there. Thoroughly recommend it.
They've done a great job with the app. The app, it's all your information in the one spot. It's available. You've got the Apple, I've got the Android. Works magnificently on both.
Here we go, we're ready for the start of the second quarter in the opening game of the second round here in Shenzhen between Czech Republic and Brazil. Brazil down by four, ready to inbound the ball with Leandro Barbosa.
I mean, the pool games we were calling, I don't think we saw more than 30 seconds of zone defense in all the games we played, and here we have the Czech Republic. I like the way they mix it up. A little bit of full court press, a little bit of zone, keep the opposition guessing, and don't let them get comfortable.
Caboclo, on to Felicio. The rebound, Bohatchik. Balvin. Moved around the perimeter all the way to the far side to Schild. Back into Balvin up against Felicio. Far side of the paint. One on one. Going to take him on. Steps into the paint. Lovely soft touch over the top of Felicio, the NBAer.
They do. And that just time. Single coverage down low. Keeps making moves like that. They're going to have to rethink their strategy.
Marcelino. Goes right through the paint, back out to Marquinhos, who's in for the first time, takes the contested three-pointer over the top of Schill. Well wide of the basket. Balvin is down on the deck again with Felicio this time. The foul called on the Brazilian underneath. Felicio averaged 12 and a half minutes per game in the NBA with the Bulls last season. Andre Balvin playing in the EuroLeague. Two very talented big men. Pumprilla. Chance to attack. Marcelino one-on-one on the far side. Back out to Schild, who's very good from the perimeter, but misses that one.
Has he been? He's been almost 69.2% from the three-point line. Extraordinary. 9 of 13 before that one.
Marcelino Huertas. And Brazil are back within four. He's looked very lively early on, his first score. Calvin will roll inside, it'll come back out to the perimeter. Alder on the turnaround, in and out. Marquinhos working with Felicio far side. Back again to Felicio, up against Balvin. Against the double team, passes back out. A two-man basketball as Marquinhos puts it in.
It is good work by Marquinhos. He missed that last three and didn't shy away from it. Comes back and knocks down the mid-range up. That'll do his confidence the world of good as well.
Another veteran, 35 years of age. High off the window. Balvin not once but twice with the tip. Using every centimetre of his 2m17 frame.
Yeah, he's been impressive to the point where it had a great low post move three plays ago. I'm surprised they just haven't gone back to that and milked it.
Huertas hitting two in quick succession.
That's what we're talking about with those on-ball screens. If you're going to sit back and just rim protect and you're trying to fight over the top of the screens, those shots are going to be on all night. Balvin needs to be a little higher.
Here he goes inside again, and he stuffs it down off the pass from Schild. A big Balvin battering ram of a blow.
And that's what happens when you come too high and you don't have that third man rotation. Good defense on the ball carrier. Hit the roll up, no rotation, slam dunk.
Now look at Leandro Barbosa go. He'll have to earn them both from the foul line. Still got that burst of pace at the age of 36.
Does he ever? And looks in spectacular condition as well. Just for a man who's seen the absolute very best in this sport. Finding his way into the paint, draws the contact. There you see the other side of that third man rotation coming very, very late. Big difference between the two. And we saw offense beating the defense on both occasions. The Czech Republic sitting off and just having the guy guarding the screen and guard that paint and make him shoot hopefully contested twos. And then the other end, we saw Brazil trying a hard show on the on ball and get beaten on the roll.
Balvin goes to the bench on 11 points in 12 minutes, 5 of 7 from the field, 4 rebounds as well. Two of those on the offensive glass. Barbosa at the line, looking to close the gap to two. No problem from the veteran. Five players on this Brazil roster at 35 years or older. Shilbin to Satoransky. Across to the far side, high catch for Kruban. Kruban trying to shake off the attentions of Barbosa, and Alder cutting through the paint, scores off the window.
Great read by Alder. Unstructured play. The set broke down, and then it just relies on the passing and the cutting and good off the ball movement. Creates an easy scoring opportunity.
Marcelino Huertas looking to orchestrate the offense, the third most assists in the World Cup since 1994. And what a pass to Barbosa. Only Prigioni and Ricky Rubio have more assists.
Huertas there and Barbosa. Looked like they were arguing about who was going to run the point. And then ends up with an easy two.
Satoransky looking to work on the outside with Alder. He gets a free look for three, chooses to go on the dribble drive instead, switches to the left hand and gets fouled midair by Caboclo.
Alder there, good drive. Saw the defense were there, perhaps a little deep, but still just attacks the rim and draws the foul. And that's pretty much the game these days. The mid-range is very uncommon. It's all about getting to the rim, shooting a three, because that's what the analytics say you should be doing. But now that time, Alder taking advantage of the work around the glass.
8.7 points, 5 rebounds on average in the first round. He had 16 points and 9 boards in the big win over Turkey when he was 7 of 11 from the field.
Yeah, well, that was by far the standout game. That was those, every one of those rebounds and points were vital. And
Alex, all the way across to Barbosa in the corner. Czech Republic did a good job of getting back. Barbosa goes behind the back, lost it on the dribble, and now a chance for Hruban. It's Brazil's turn to work back quickly. Satoransky, oh, basket side, beautiful pass, simple finish for Krejci.
I think you're underselling with beautiful. That was a spectacular pass. Looked very simple, but that absolutely had to be pinpoint. Huertas just on the high side, gets caught out, and just great touch, just over the outstretched arms. That is a gorgeous pass.
Fourth assist for Satoransky in the first half, and Czech Republic back up by 6. Timeout call by Brazil.
Coach Alexander Petrovic just a little anxious and concerned about some of the goings on out there. Offensively, they haven't been terrible. And there's the great man, the all-time greatest, Oscar Schmidt.
One of just two players ahead of you in the all-time scorers list now.
I tell you what, a man of his size, yeah, little kiss for his beautiful wife. Very obviously cheering on his Brazilian team, who he did some spectacular work over many years.
6 points, the Czech lead. Ball in the hands of Barbosa for Brazil. Felicio off to Marcelino. Huertas just inside, back into Felicio. Felicio through a gap with his power, and he'll go to the line for two.
Easy. Anytime a big that's got the athleticism can get that close. Not bad outside the charge circle, but that one dribble and just powers up between two. And
Coach Alexander Petrovic's team, you talked about them not being bad on the offensive end. They haven't started well on the defensive end at any point in this World Cup. They've conceded 20 points or more in the first quarter of three of their four games now.
The thing that worried me about the long term of this game with the Czech Republic, from what we've seen, whenever Balvin has not been in the game, it is a different look to the on the defensive end in particular for this Czech Republic. He is so vital at that end of the floor. I doubt we'll see him on the sidelines too long.
Blake Schilb looking to work with Alder on the perimeter. He moves inside, Satoransky receives it. He'll shoot the three over the top of the smaller Marcelino, halfway down and back out again. Barbosa, Garcia to the corner to Marcelino Huertas. Felicio looking to run interference, moves inside. Far side is Alex, and Felicio, the pass picked off by Schilb in front of him. Great read by the defense. Great pace by the offense as well, and Hruban nails it in transition. Czech Republic by 7 over Brazil. And their second three-pointer. Alder. Hruban. Turns it over. He's not happy with the call.
Clearly, I don't know what he's complaining about. He just lost. Hruban there just lost the dribble. And sometimes you might just give that look because the coach is a long, long way away, just to maybe suggest, oh, hang on, that was a dud call. I didn't actually mess it up.
Fourth turnover of the half for Czech Republic. One more than Brazil. Look at the passing ability of Marcelino Huertas again to Alex, who drives inside, aggressive play. Misses the shot though, Marquinhos it was rather. Satoransky back out, wide open. Blake Schilb, the sharpshooter.
honestly, the performance he's had, as we said, coming in this game, 9 of 13, he's now 1 for 2 from the three-point line. That is off the charts, three-point shooting.
Here is Alex on the baby hook. Wouldn't go down. Czech Republic up by double figures and a chance to stretch this advantage. And with Balvin on the bench as well. Look at Saleransky, 7 points, 5 assists, 4 rebounds. A remarkable half from him. Just seems to get better and better. Looking for another assist here. High off the window. It was wild, but how about the putback from Patrick Helder? The ball magnetized to his hands off the window.
Yeah, they look energized, don't they? And this time just coming in, clearly. No box out. Gets a clear path to the basket. The ball bounces his way. Another great pass. Saleransky. And when it's as easy as that, any wonder they see a timeout.
Well, Saleransky is running the show. 5 assists already. All of his teammates benefiting. There's a long, long way to go, but we've never had a triple-double in the World Cup. He's almost halfway towards one.
And he's done it in real spectacular fashion as well. Extraordinarily unselfish. He can shoot with the best of them, Saleransky. Got good range on his shot, but the way in which that he brings other people to the game, and that's when you, one of the great assets of any of the elite players, your ability to make those around you better. It's a skill you can't practice. It's an instinct for the game, and he's got it.
We're selling him short with that stat line. There's 2 steals on there as well. Doing a bit of everything. Tomasz Saleransky. Varejão. Barbosa. Behind the back, behind Varejão as well, to the far side, Alex. Barbosa firing it in. Varejão almost looking like he had a push in the back, but the official's saying no.
Well, he tried to sell it, put way too much mayo on it, and threw himself out of the play. So, 4th turnover now for Brazil. And they just had some good looks, but the defensive effort. Coach Petrovic now changing things up. Has a look at a 2-3 zone, and he won't stay in it for very long. If they're the types of shots they're going to give up.
Easy for Helder, easy to get the ball into him, and the lead has stretched to 15.
I like the look because Czech Republic were having their way with him on the offensive end, so have a look at a zone.
Alex with the heave 3 over the top of the defense. Brazil can't buy a bucket at the moment. Saleransky like a shark that smells blood here. Patrick Helder backing in, going to work on Barbosa. Offensive foul.
Helder there throwing the right arm out. Didn't try to disguise it at all. And rightfully gets pinged for the offensive foul.
Man who'll play in the French top flight with Boulazac this season. Played in Italy last year.
Actually, on replay, Barbosa. Certainly an offensive foul, but Barbosa did a good job tangling his arms up. And that's there you saw that last play, the little slip on the 2-3 zone. Easy entry pass, easy layup. It's interesting to see if Brazil persist with it.
And Helder goes to the bench on 9 points in 12 minutes. And the other centre, Balvin, has 11 points. So it's the two bigs for Czech Republic dominating on the interior.
You see Krish. Not a lot in that. He bumped the cutter, and I think it was the second whack that he had at him that caused him the foul. That is Krish.
Here's Hafalouz on the back cut behind the defense. Got the floater to fall.
And that's what they needed. Well,
only 10 of 28 before that. And you're struggling from the field. Those cheap baskets, little backdoor cuts, scores around the rim. Become all that much more vital. One, to keep the scoreboard ticking over, but just to generate some confidence. Lee was starting to get to that really difficult territory. And there you see what happens, trying to fight over the top of the screen. And called for the offense, for the defensive foul.
Four fouls for each team, a minute and a half to go in the first half. Czech Republic by 13, Sadaransky to get the ball in, looking for Schilp. Fires it back, what a pass that is! Doing a bit of Sadaransky-esque passing to say, well, you have a score now.
They're just picking them off. Well structured, they understand their roles in the team, and unselfish. It's a real good combination.
Here they come again with Wojtek Kruban. The Czechs are running riot at the moment. Balvin underneath, can he grab it? No, big effort from Caboclo just to touch it to his teammate. Down by 15, in desperate need of something here. A big final 45 seconds to this first half. Varejão. Alex, far side, step to the side, way off on the window. Didn't get his geometry right. Sadaransky. He'll take his time, an 11-second differential. Sadaransky was looking for Balvin. Alex playing some suffocating one-on-one defense. Kruban, shot clock down to three. Alex on Kruban as well, forces the steal. Another wonderful piece of defense in the open floor for Hafalus.
I like it. It's what Brazil needed. Timeout called. Czech Republic want to work something out for this last 9.9 seconds, but they need to see more of that. They're up and in the lanes. They're making it tough to distribute the ball, and that time they get lucky with a little deflection. But the energy levels on that last position, now possession, but admittedly, they knew that they were playing for the last shot, so the aggressiveness of the Czech Republic wasn't quite there, but simple plays like that has led to the Czech Republic shooting at 56%, 8 of 32 from the field. And when you can get high percentage looks like that, you're going to be able to kick those numbers. Brazil in the bonus, so they've got to be careful not to send the Czech Republic to the line. They need good, fundamentally sound defense and try and prevent this last possession. Just got a little bit of momentum going into the halftime break.
Nine seconds to advance the ball for Czech Republic and trying to create a good shot. Bohacic.
Blocking foul.
Contact on the far side away from the ball. Alex and Balvin.
Balvin a little lucky. It looked like Alex was trying to get over and there was a moving screen. Can we see it here? Oh no, maybe not. Alex perhaps just grabbing Balvin. Petrovic, I think, saw it and expressing his emotion at the call because he sends Balvin to the line to shoot a couple.
Alexander Petrovic, a two-time EuroLeague champion as a player back in the mid-80s, as well as winning bronze medals with Yugoslavia at the 82 and 86 World Cups, as well as at the 84 Olympics in Los Angeles.
Balvin is probably the biggest blemish on his tournament so far. Not great from the free throw line, only shooting it at 45%.
13 the lead, and it remains as such, but an offensive rebound, will it go? No, not quite for Kruban. Brazil not protecting their own backboard and almost paid the price at the buzzer. But at the end of the first half, they trail by 13. Brazil 32, Czech Republic 45.
Yeah, real quality half of basketball from the Czech Republic's point of view. At the offensive end, they've been able to score in a variety of different ways, and hence the numbers, albeit bit down on the three-point line, but very solid for them. And on the glass, have a look at it, completely dominating, 23-13, and that's given them this healthy 13-point margin. And Brazil just not in the flow. We give a lot of credit. You see the main point scorers there. A lot of credit to the defense of the Czech Republic, but just no fluency in what they're doing, and combined with just missing some shots they'd normally make, have dug themselves a pretty deep hole that they've got to try and figure a way out of. And that man right there, he was highly impressive in the first half. That's Balvin. It wasn't just about the 11 points. It was the intimidation at the other end of the floor. He's also got the four rebounds. And he's a quality player, shooting at 5 of 7 from the field.
The three centres for Czech Republic have combined for 26 of their 45 points. 11 for Balvin, 9 for Aldis, 6 for Martin Krejc. Brazil trying to weather the Czech storm right now. And they're led by a couple of players on 7 points. Barbosa and Alex Garcia. Really struggling to deal with Czech Republic, who are flying at this World Cup and have a 13-point edge, led by those 11 points of Balvin. But how about the stat line in the first half from Satoransky? 9 points, 6 assists, 4 rebounds and 2 steals. And Brazil have to try and battle back in the second half. Do join us for that in a few minutes' time.
so much. Jump Team 10, 掌声欢迎这支高中街舞少儿团。Number 9, the Dingo.
Connection. Wide open shot there for Garino.
Oh, taking it. Oh, get that out of here! Big block from Choji. Matthew trying to get past Cohen. He does get past him. Behind the back pass to Eric, who drops it in for two.
Man, that's a highlight because we were expecting him to fly.
Now Gentile. Bounce pass into Brooks. Pass behind the back. Extra pass. Datome for three. What a team play from Italy.
That's wonderful passing behind the back. Extra pass out and across. And the three is knocked out.
Down now by Janovic, or Jovic is in all the space he wants.
Now Mike Marjanovic becomes point guard with a great no-look pass and the alley-oop finish for Serbia.
My parents gave me away, so I had no purpose in this life. Yeah. When you educate a woman, you educate a nation. It's a quote from Nelson Mandela, by the way.
Welcome back to the Shenzhen Bay Sports Centre, where Czech Republic lead Brazil 45-32 at the half. It's been a wonderful performance so far from those Czech players in blue. And the stats don't make for good reading for Brazil. They certainly do for Tomáš Satoranský. 9 points, 4 rebounds, 6 assists. Brazil have conceded 45-plus points in the first half of only 9 of their last 29 games. in the World Cup. They've lost 7 of the last 8 when they've conceded that amount in a half. Czech Republic have won both games in this World Cup when they've scored more than 43 in a half.
It is, and I think that Brazil are well down on their form so far, and a lot of credit goes to the Czech Republic, but they've got so much more to give. They've got a size advantage down the other end. They look a little bit more athletic, but just the structure and system of the Czech Republic really standing out. And the man on your team, Huertas, he's battling his heart out, the veteran, and there's so many players that you can look at with this Brazilian team that have got plenty more to give. And this second half, I think that regroup at the half time and with the veterans on board, you expect to see a much improved performance, particularly on the defensive end. The ease of which the Czech Republic have scored, and it's highlighted in those numbers you're talking about. 55% of the field is way too much, and that, not always, but often can be reflective of the defensive intensity.
Brazil shooting just 36% from the field. They haven't won any of the 10 games in which they were trailing by 13 or more points at halftime in the history of the FIBA World Cup. Now, it's not a massive margin. You do feel Brazil can't get any worse. Czech Republic maybe can't get any better. It's surely going to get closer.
Well, that's true. Yeah, you never like to go into a half where you've got to create history for your team. And so that's certainly can't be ignored, but they have the capacity. You look at this Brazilian team and what they've done over the first 3 games, they certainly have the capacity to play at a lot higher rate, but they've dug themselves a hole, and now is a real test. It's that character test that you've got with some veterans to be able to see if they can't turn things around. But it's not just going to be guile that gets them through here. It's got to be aggression on the, particularly on the defensive end. And there is again the great Oscar Schmidt, the all-time points leader in Olympic Games history. I tell you, they could use him out. 6'9", can shoot it from anywhere, and absolutely no conscience whatsoever. It was a thing of beauty to watch the great man do his work. Not so good to be playing against, but great to watch.
And it's been a thing of beauty to watch this performance from Czech Republic so far. And Brazil have to rise to the Czech challenge in the second half, down by 13. We'll try and listen in to the head coaches.
For me, they've got problems at both ends of the floor, there's no doubt about that, but for me, the biggest focus has to be at the defensive end. They've got enough experience out there, they're going to be able to create some shots and knock some shots down, but right now, having to shoot over 90 in the game, and they've only given up 32, so they need a marked improvement in the second half at that end of the floor.
Ronan Ginzburg there, the head coach of Czech Republic, will be very happy with what he's seen of his team. We talked about there being 6 Nymburk players on the roster. He was head coach of Nymburk for a decade until 2017, winning the Czech League every season.
Well, I don't know too many clubs in the world in any sport that have won at any division, at any level, to pull off 16 in a row. I mean, that is extraordinary result for a club, and full credit to them. And as such, when you've got 6 national team players on your club team, that's probably a big reason why they've had so much success.
Here's Sadaratsky, who plays in the NBA with the Wizards. Very much a part of this team, though, as he finds Krejci, one of those 6 Nymburk players who had it knocked away, able to recover in the backcourt. Sadaratsky looking to work with Balvin on the perimeter, creating a bit of room for Sadaratsky, who gets it to fall up to 11.
Well, that's not the start they were looking for. Easy free throw for Sadaransky. Came off a screen, and with the first half that he's had, to get that wide open is such an easy shot. Not a good sign for Brazil.
And the lead up to 15, which I believe ties the largest of the game. Brazil need to answer back. It's a one-on-one move from Alex, spinning down the baseline. Marquinhos will go for the deep three.
That's a metre and a half behind the three-point line. And he's trailing it by 15. You need to get a better quality shot than that.
Satoransky around the frame of Balvin, trying to thread the eye of the needle. Caboclo was there. Able to read the passing lane and intercept. Caboclo. Marquinhos. Cafalouz. Varejão. Varejão backing in against Balvin. Little head fake. Marquinhos, they're struggling to create a good look. Caboclo on the fadeaway corner three. It's not the ideal shot.
Varejão gets the lucky break, slapped the ball. And just coming off the leg of Valdin.
Marquinhos will take on the long two and Brazil finally gets something.
Well, he's coming out aggressively on the offensive end and clearly not going to die wondering.
A man who's been with Flamengo in Brazil since 2012, won five league titles in that time. Satoransky will take the three, calm and composed on the perimeter.
The technique is beautiful as well.
14 altogether, 5 points in the opening 2 minutes of the second half for him. Cafalouz swings it on mid-air to Alex, who can't answer back. Balvin a rebound again. Bohatchik, cross-court pass to Satoransky. And a foul on Caboclo.
Just doesn't seem to be any of that real start in the Brazilian offense. They're getting the ball through hands, they're swinging the ball. There's been a bit of ball and player movement, but not very effective. There was that very first shot that we spoke about, Satoransky, and then again, that time at least a contested three, but nothing but the bottom of the net.
He's 2 of 3 from the outside now. Satoransky en route to those 14 points. Bohatchik going past Balvin, who was trying to grab the offensive rebound. And instead, it was Hruban who did, and the basket will count.
Just stayed with the play. Just got there. Too easy. Wanted it a little bit more. Need to see a little bit more desperation going on here from the Brazilian team.
17 and a half minutes to go, but it is getting desperate for Brazil. Another miss. And Satoransky looking to run the show here. Back out. Balvin across to Bohatchik. Inside, flips it over. Varejão right off the window. Got it to fall. And Czech Republic stretched the lead to 20.
This is getting ugly. Very sloppy. Ball movement. And the speed in which that ball was swung around doesn't stall in anyone's hands. It's either pass it, penetrate it, or shoot it. And everyone seems connected. Everyone knows where the next phase of the offense is supposed to be. Really good stuff by the Czech Republic.
There's Alex spinning into traffic and losing it. Brazil almost running out of ideas. Satoransky to the far side, three-point shot, Hruban. And the lead remains at 20. Alex, determined to keep on going, looking to find the 20-year-old Iago, who's just come in. And a timeout called, 3.5 minutes into the second half. A lead that was 13 at the break is now 20 for Czech Republic. And Brazil have all kinds of problems.
Now it's tempo time. Beat the drums as hard as you can.
Not the sort of start that Brazil was hoping for. And they're so renowned for the emotive, passionate way in which they go about it. We've seen none of that here today. And they haven't had a lot to get excited about, but even some of the earlier made baskets, it's sort of
workmanlike rather than emotive, and that's not traditionally what you see from the South American teams, and in particular Brazil.
Satoransky very much the star of the show, but it's very much a team game that Czech Republic are playing, and they are blowing Brazil to bits at the moment. Varejão almost had it picked off. What's the call on the baseline?
I think it's out of bounds, and they're calling it on Rumbang.
Yago will inbound to Caboclo. Varejão hands it off to Yago, just 20 years of age. Didn't play in the first half. He takes on the three-pointer here, another miss. It'll ricochet kindly for Brazil, though. Brazil only 2 of 14 from three-point range. Alex Varejão just couldn't grab the low pass. And the quick pass down the floor, Bohatchik back out. Satoransky will slow it down.
Right idea down the other end of the floor. They got the switch, but just a poor pass into Varejão.
Satoransky with Balvin rolling inside. Found by Satoransky, knocked away by Varejão. Still Czech Republic ball.
Here we see the help coming off the on-ball screen. Varejão a little late. And that roll is coming. If there's not going to be a switch or a hard show or any of those circumstances where you require some sort of help, you need that third man coming in a lot earlier than that.
Deep inbound Satoransky to Wojtek Kruban. Shakes off the defense. Would it roll for him though? Yago so quick, going coast to coast, down the floor, got contact, and he'll go to the line, putting his body on the line.
It is, and the early transition, maybe something they need to try and push, because they've been blanketed in the half court, and the little fella.
Yago. Without trying to be disrespectful, the first half performance from Brazil looked like a performance of 35, 36-year-olds, and Yago, the 20-year-old, just injecting a spark for Brazil.
Now, you're spot on. They do look slow. They don't look as passionate. The offense is just being moved. They're getting some good ball movement, but it's ineffective movement. And very few threats on the basket. And Balvin does a good job of working those on balls and protecting the rim. Haven't been too many easy looks, and that's where transition basketball can help you. Just throw caution to the wind, try and make it an up-tempo game.
18 the difference. Satoransky, Bohatchik pulls up for the outside shot, rebound Caboclo. Brazil maybe a chance to build momentum here. Barbosa with the ball, looking to find Varejão, turns it over into the hands of Satoransky, the last man you want it to be with. Out of bounds, off a Brazil body.
And that is more like this type of defense you want to have on the pick and roll. That time Satoransky knew it was coming. He was guarding the weak side guy, dropped off, played in the middle, and then just picked off that pass.
Bohatchik, Satoransky, looking to take on Barbosa and got the reach in. His first and the first on Brazil at the midway point of the third quarter. George Ginsberg's Czech Republic do have three fouls to their name. Schill. Bohatchik runs interference on the perimeter, receives the ball, looks to put it on the floor, stops and pops at the foul line, can't get the drop. Caboclo a towering rebound. Barbosa.
Everything breaking down, slowing down into a half-court game.
Barbosa looking to bundle his way to the basket, but nowhere near in the end. Kreisch onto the corner, Bohatchik for three. Varejão a rebound. Brazil are playing with fire at the moment. Barbosa, can he get this one to drop? Yes, he can. Leandro Barbosa, the veteran, stepping up to try and pull Brazil out of a big hole.
It was Yago before in the transition, this time Barbosa. And and this is where they've looked their most threatening. Getting out early in transition and putting some heat on the rim. Like a timeout, still hold a healthy 16-point lead, but just momentum going away. Balhachik coming down the last three possessions and having some really good looks. The offense wasn't poor, they just missed some shots. And Brazil pushing it up the floor and creating something in transition.
9 points for Leandro Barbosa now, who led Brazil with 14.3 on average in the first round. Brazil have scored the last 4 points to close the gap down to 16. Satoransky. Balvin handing off to Schill. Howder had it knocked away, able to gather. Bohatchik to Satoransky, 10 to work with. Satoransky had it poked from behind, pocket picked, and here goes Yago down the floor behind the back. Barbosa, get out of here, says Bohatchik. 3-point shot, Brazil will go. They'll upgrade to a 3. Vitor Benic, who struggled from the field in the tournament, hitting a big one when it matters.
That's the sort of spark they need. Gain some momentum, start to play with that flair and emotion that we come to expect from the Brazilian players and teams.
Schilb looking to ride contact to the rim. Still going to be Czech Republic ball. And the deficit down to 13, as it was at the half.
It's amazing when you see the ball go in the hole, you start to create some momentum on the offensive end. All of a sudden, the defense starts to pick up a little bit more defensive pressure. Tougher shot that time for the Czech Republic. Some good signs here for Brazil.
Satoransky, he's going to take the three himself. Nothing but net for Satoransky.
The momentum snapper right there. Satoransky, timely by their superstar.
Barbosa bundling to the baseline this time, got it back off Farajal. Caboclo to the far side, deep three-point attempt. Hits two in a row, Vitor Benic getting Brazil back in business. And he cancels out the three from Satoransky. 13 the differential again, and a foul on Barbosa. Vitor Benic, only 4 of 19 from the field in the first round. He did average 12.3 points per game in qualifying. He's finally finding his form.
We didn't see it on camera there, but we talk about the stats of Satoransky. That time just huddling the guys together and getting him back on page. Great leadership.
Bohatchik will get it to go with the contact. He took on Caboclo and won.
The whole body language you see from the Czech Republic as well. Bohatchik just putting his head down, goes with his preferred left. Not a lot of contact on that one, but gets the and one. In contrast, even that last possession, you see Benic make those 3-pointers. It's still, the bench is not up into the game, waving towels and getting into it.
He can't hit the and one. He was only 2 of 12 from the field, Bohatchik, before that driving layup, but still full of confidence. Yago, the 20-year-old, has some confidence as well. He can't hit the three. There's another rebound for Satoransky. Schild moving it swiftly into Alder. And a foul on the floor.
Caboclo just reaching in on that one. It's called for the reach-in foul. Satoransky, this is a pivotal moment. They take him out of the game to give him a spell, log some significant minutes. Satoransky already played the 25 minutes
give him a quick blow, try and keep him out of this until quarter time, get another couple of minutes, three-quarter time.
Balveen handing off to Belhatcher. High and in from Balveen. What a lovely swift pass. The lead is back to 17 for Czech Republic. Barbosa gets it back from Iago. Barbosa away from Balveen. Left hand layup, lovely underarm.
Showing his class there. Speed reads the defense, puts it to the deck, and a very nice finish with the left.
Barbosa, the first Brazilian up to double figures, now has 11. Schilb spins away and almost got it to go off the window himself, but he'll go to the line to earn them from the stripe.
Had a good size advantage on Benich. They take advantage of it. I like the recognition. Come down there. All the misdirection, passing, ball movement. That's great. But there are times you see a mismatch that you like. Put them on the box, throw it in there, and let them go to work and take advantage of it.
Felicio is in for Varejão for Brazil. Schilb is at the line. This is the first. Blake Schilbert, Euro Cup champion with Galatasaray back in 2016. He's in France now with Chalon Rams. The gap. A minute and a half to go in the third. Barbosa really starting to heat up here. Barbosa somehow found a way through a gap that didn't appear to be there.
Well, it wasn't according to the officials. They've called an offensive foul, a charging foul on Barbosa. Let's have a look. Does split the gap. Ooh. Alda just shuffling to the left. For mine, that's a block. Always tough, a bang-bang play like that. Very, very tough on the officials. In fact, the hardest call in the game.
Third foul on Barbosa.
They go to it again.
Schilb up against Barbosa, shoots over the top of him and got the contact. A chance at a three-point play, but he's down here.
Landed on Barbosa's foot and he's rolled his ankle. So this would be a huge blow. Have a look at, oh yes, the left foot. The ankle rolls over. It's not a person that's played any sort of length of time on a basketball floor that hasn't experienced that. And hopefully it's not too bad. Teammates just trying to encourage him because they know how important he is. He really does spread the floor, shooting over 69% from the three-point line. Can't give him daylight. And how's the work in the last two possessions down low? On the box, just throw it into him. And he's going to have to leave the floor by the look of it. So whoever subbed in is going to be the one taking the free throw.
Blake Schilb here in the appreciation of the fans here in Shenzhen. That is a big blow for Czech Republic. One of their hottest shooters.
Not just for this game either. When you think of the schedule ahead, hopefully it's just one of those stingers that might be a little swelling, get a day off tomorrow, get some treatment, and you'll still be in discomfort whenever you do something like that. But hopefully it's nothing too serious. Sure, the officials have gone to the bench.
It gets into the cylinder, but it doesn't extend too much the leg. It's a normal foul. But one shot we got, huh? Confirmed, no. Yes, normal foul.
Yeah, there was nothing intentional about that. That's great insight that we're able to provide. Get the first-hand look at what's going on, the decision-making process that the officials go through.
FIBA giving you a front-row seat for the World Cup here in 2019. Wojtek Hruban will take the foul shot, completes the three-point play. That was Barbosa's fourth foul, so he's dangling by a disciplinary thread now, Leandro Barbosa. 19 is the lead with 11 minutes to play. Benic lost it. Balvin came up with it.
Balvin does a good job. That time the hard show on the on ball, a little trap and forces the turnover.
Bohacic combining with Balvin. Kruban, Alder looking to go to work on Alex near side of the paint. Alder looking up to the rim, looking back out to the perimeter, maybe to Balvin, couldn't find anybody. And a foul on Bohacic as Yago moved away from him.
Just a hint there of perhaps an unsportsmanlike. One of the great things that FIBA have done over the last couple of years is try to eliminate those, well, really intentional fouls just to stop the transition. And that time there, I'm not sure if you went through all the points. There's five major points that you've got to go through, whether that one might have had a hint of unsportsmanlike about it.
Czech Republic did have that foul to give. Four for them in the quarter now. There's a five-second differential between shot and game clock at the end of the third. Brazil holding it for as long as they possibly can. Yago finding Felicio. And the ball out of bounds in Brazil's favour with 2.6 left on the shot clock.
Felicio not happy. See how deep Balvin is right in that paint. And good positioning. Nothing wrong with that. It's just good defense.
So Yago Matius to inbound the ball. We're going to have a change here for Czech Republic. Martin Krysh comes in. Patrick Alder to the bench. Brazil have to be quick. Felicio hands it off. It's put up at the buzzer by Alex. A chance still for Czech Republic. A couple of seconds remaining. It's going to be Kruban for the three. Wouldn't go down, but Czech Republic still with a very healthy lead. They have stretched a 13-point halftime advantage by a further six, up 65-46 at the end of three.
Himself more now. Defense, of course. Now, when number two plays the pick and roll, you are not supposed to be so high, okay? We need to go over a window and they look for the pass. If he drive, block it, okay? But we look for the pass. We are good inside when he starts playing, right? Let's go.
I tell you, I cannot be more impressed with Ronan Ginzborg and the way he's got this team playing. He, for mine, one of the better coaching performances, and that's not underselling his talent at all. It's just they look organized, they mix it up on the defensive end, he shows some different looks, seems to have a really good feel for the game. Outstanding work by him, and most importantly, getting the absolute very best out of the talent at his disposal.
They've got such a real chemistry, which you might have expected from the six players who play their club basketball with Nymburk, the Czech champions. But how about the other six players have all come in and been able to create the same chemistry?
Well, that's right. And when you've got an established culture and you've got guys that perhaps don't spend as much time with them, it's very hard for them to come in and change that culture. You're almost compelled to fit in. And that's how it appears with this group. It's been an absolute delight to see and watch.
Balvin and Satoransky combined for 30 points between them. Satoransky, the only player to have 11 points, 6 rebounds and 6 assists in 3 games at this World Cup already. He's way above that here, 17.7 rebounds and 6 assists.
And with this nice little buffer they've got, they just keep him on the bench a little longer, get him a little bit more rest.
Yago will take the three. Brazil may have to light it up from long range if they're to get back into this one.
Well, that's right. They need someone needs to catch fire from the three-point line. They haven't been they're only 4 of 19.
Bohacic with the open three. He shows them how it's done.
And down the other end of the floor, it's a double whammy. That stinks.
Alex into the lane, passing lanes blocked off again, another turnover Brazil, It's going from bad to worse for them.
Tremendous effort by Alex, but just no plan. Just driving into the traffic and throwing it up.
And they turn it right back over to Brazil. It's Alex across to the far side to Iago. Cross-court pass, high catch, Benny. She's hit a couple from the outside already, and he hits another. He's the one who looks the most likely.
And that's the thing, and that's where you're most vulnerable. In the defensive transition, you're prepared to take that three ball. And they really got to throw caution to the wind.
Brazil 5 of 20 from long range. He's 3 of 4, though. Caboclo stepped on the baseline. It's 19 points, the deficit, with 8 minutes and 43 seconds to play. Garcia goes to the bench.
Gigi Lozada comes in. Another youngster, only 20 years of age.
The problem throughout for Brazil has been defense. They conceded at least 20 points in each of the first three quarters.
How easy was that for Alda?
On the turnaround, a foul on the three-point shot, so Benic, Czech Republic, very concerned about his form on the perimeter. They foul him, and he'll go to the line for three.
He's 3 or 4 from the three-point line. He's looked very smooth. And you said he'll have 3 attempts at it.
He's 3 of 4. The rest of the team are 2 of 16. They need each and every point they can get right now, Alexander Petrovic's team, as Benic misses the first foul shot.
And you know, right now it's not just about trying to salvage this and get the win for Brazil, but they also need to start to think of ways in which you can just reduce the margin. If there's a three-way tie and the margin between those teams becomes vital, a blowout does you no good.
Bohacic to the far side. Pomprela from deep. Czech Republic just keep on coming. Iago back out to Marquinhos. 23 the advantage now. Iago finding Felicio on the reverse, got it to go. Felicio's second score of the game.
In contrast, this margin for Czech Republic is crucial. They got to keep just trying to crush it and get as big a win as they possibly can.
Pomprela has 5 quickfire points. Gigi looking to meander through the paint. Balvin the rebound. Here comes Saturansky. Across to the far side. Bohacic threatened the three. Clings onto it. To the baseline. Bounce pass inside. And Alda puts it in. Look at the ball movement. The confidence. The spring. And the belief in the Czech Republic side.
Right now, if you Greece, you're probably barracking for Brazil to try and shorten this margin, because if the USA beat Greece, then on Monday Greece will need to beat the Czech Republic by more than the Czech beat Brazil. So there's some interesting onlookers with the teams on the sideline as well.
26 is that margin now. Gigi onto Iago, the 220-year-olds on court for Brazil. The veterans haven't been able to get it done. The coach turning to the youth.
Nothing going right. That time Saturansky just did it and just came off Iago. Everything going the way of the Czech Republic.
Coming off the rails for Brazil, who only scored 14 points in the third quarter, their lowest scoring quarter at the World Cup. 6 so far here in the fourth. Bodies down on the deck, wrestling for it, just for one possession. They need to show they're up for the fight here, Brazil. Otherwise, it could end up being the end of the line for them. And they came here winning each of their first three games, knowing a win would take them into the quarterfinals. The Czech Republic knew they had to win. And boy, have they responded.
It's not just the fact that they've won, it's the way they've won that would give the Czech fans, Czech Republic fans, a whole bunch of hope about not just making it to the elimination round, but causing some problems from then on for whoever they may face.
Benic, Felicio, Gigi Lusada. Gigi into the lane, trying to squeeze a pass in a passing lane that wasn't there. Oh. Felicio playing hotcake and putting it in. Four the difference. Satoransky, 17 points, 8 assists, 7 rebounds, 9 points and a chance, 19 points and a chance to hit 20.
And as a coach, that would disappoint you when you start. Look, he starts beyond the 3-point line from the wing and he's able to get right into the charge circle. Now, Fuertes has got to do a better job of guarding the ball. But someone's got to be on that weak side underneath the basket on the split line to help, to provide that help defense. They're just not connected right now, Brazil, on the defensive end, or for that matter, on the offensive end.
And this has been some performance from Tomasz Satoransky, up to 20 points. Here's Benic, back out, Huertas across to the far side, Gigi stepping inside, looking to attack. Forced away by the defense and nothing falling for Brazil. Pumprela. Balvin hands it off to the star of the show, Satoransky. Balvin coming out to set the screen. Satoransky trying to weave it inside. Deflects away off the body of Marquinhos and a whistle.
Seeing he's not happy. Looked like it came off his hip. Well, that's what at least they're complaining about, saying it wasn't a kick. But the referees deem it was, and shot clock resets to 14.
Wow. Satoransky floating one high. Brazil hit with a heat check at the World Cup.
That is just fantastic offense, but gee whiz, that defense, very porous.
Assist number 9 for Satoransky. Huertas for 3, got it. One back for Brazil. Those points very much at a premium for them, though. It's a double-double for Balvin at 15 points, 10 rebounds now. Pumprela. Lost it, but it's still Czech Republic ball, and all eyes for these final 4.5 minutes will be on Tomasz Satoransky, who's got 20 points, 9 assists and 7 rebounds. There has never before been a triple-double in the history of the FIBA World Cup.
And that surprises me when you think of some of the great players that have come through over the years.
Bo Hatchett from the outside beats the buzzer.
Everything falling for the Czech Republic. Except
we're
that.
Just getting away.
Except that. A nice little inside-out move by on that time there. But see, every time now, the Czech Republic, they're just milking the clock. They're going to be in no hurry.
Oh, it just got past Balvin after the nice idea from Alder. Talk about that triple-double. Joe Ingles had 17 points, 10 rebounds, 9 assists in the earlier in the tournament, back in the first round. Satoransky only the second player for more than 15 points, 7 rebounds and 7 assists in this tournament. 3-point shot, Brazil falls short. Balvin going down to get it. It's a long way down for him. Bo Hatchett to the far side. Pumprela. Alder. and Kruban.
Gigi not giving up on the play, fighting over the top of the screen. That time just a little too aggressive. Gigi will be taking his talents to the Sydney Kings next season. Early second round draft pick in this year's draft.
Wirtz, who's been scoring a few points recently, stopped that time on his route to the rim.
They're not giving up, are they? They haven't taken the foot off the pedal at any stage of the Czech Republic, and that's absolutely required when you think of what may lie ahead.
Marquinhos for the three. We are going to have a timeout with 3 minutes and 14 seconds remaining. Czech Republic up by 24, but each and every point could prove pivotal here if these two need to go to a tiebreaker at the end of the second round.
Yeah, it's not just, you mentioned a tie-break situation. It's not, may not just be with this team. It becomes a three-way tie, and then percentages or differences, points difference between the three teams that are tied, and only those two, three teams come into play. So there's a lot of different permutations that still can come about.
Brazil about to fall to 3-1. Czech Republic about to rise to 3-1. One more game to play for these two in the second round. The margin crucial. Satoransky looks to continue doing what he's been doing all game long. Balvin on the inside. Satoransky looking towards the basket. Back out to Bohatchik. Into the lane. He hangs but can't hit, but he'll go to the line for two.
Of all the players in the competition that we've seen, and we've seen some beauties that the French team just stacked from 1 to 10. Of all the players in the team that I would love to play with, Satoransky is that player, because when called upon in a crisis, he knows it's his time and he can step up individually. But the way in which he creates for others and makes those around him better is an absolute delight to watch. Incredibly unselfish and plays with a very high basketball IQ.
Bohatchik from the line, buries it. Satoransky needs just one more assist to become just the second player in the World Cup since 1994 to combine 20 plus points and 10 plus assists. He's been that good here this evening. Quotas. Across to the far side to Gigi. Shot clock to five here. Step to the side. Three-pointer for Marquinhos. And Kruban the rebound.
There you see the difference. Brazil go through their system. Some good movement. Swung it from side to side. Nice little shuffle cut, but got very little out of their offense.
Paterka underneath, picking up the pieces. Brazil have conceded at least 20 points in every quarter.
Needless to say, that's way too many. And it's not just the fact that the number of points, it's the percentages as well. 57% from the field.
Huertas, Marcelino Huertas has been stepping up with a few points here down the stretch. He's got 11 now. Joint highest for Brazil with Leandro Barbosa. But 24 the deficit.
I thought Satoransky was the one that was coming out, and I thought, come on, coach, someone needs to get a message to him. We need one more assist to get that 20 and 10.
It doesn't look like he'll get the triple-double now, though. Three rebounds and an assist short with time running out. Goes away from the screen set by Krejci. They move it around the perimeter. So smooth and well-oiled, but it falls short for Peterka. And then a whistle because Brazil have a player down.
He looks in considerable pain too. Holding Quinos. His knee. Quinos with a knee. Let's hope that's not too serious. Let's have a look. Silence. Ooh. Always worry about those ones when players go down. It didn't look like there was any contact. May have been a hint of a knee on knee, but if that's the case, that's what you'd be hoping for. A little sting up, little corky, whatever it may be. And unfortunately, the coach has no flair for the theatrics, and he takes Satoransky out of the game.
A huge smile on his face as he gets the high fives and the pats on the back all round. Tomasz Satoransky, 20 points, 9 assists, 7 rebounds, 3 steals and 2 blocks.
Yeah, that is some sort of game. Unlike some leagues around the world, some of those statistics are a lot more closely monitored. In FIBA basketball, you see the assists in some leagues, and you go, oh my goodness. There's a pass, 2 dribbles, a shot fake. Knocks down a shot, and they still get an assist for it. Here, not so much.
Final minute and a half. Brazil down by 24. These two about to level up their win-loss records. Cross court to Caboclo from the outside, buries it. Brazil's still aware that each and every point could make the difference in a tie. If it's a three-way tie, of course, if these two are tied, then Czech Republic would win it on the head-to-head after winning this game.
My word, and it's a big occasion for Greece coming up. Puts a little bit more pressure on them to get the win.
Final minute of this one. Marcelino Huertas. Gigi Lusada. And there's a whistle underneath. Brazil set to lose by more than 20 points for just the third time at the World Cup this century.
Well, you've gone a little early, so because there is still a bit of time, but it's fair to say that doesn't really happen all that often.
We'll try and get it below 20 here. Benic floats one off the window and does reduce the arrears to 19. Jakub Šišinar in the game. Wearing the number 13, handling the ball here. Hasn't played much of the tournament. He finds an open shooter and the three-pointer for Peterka. And they force one more turnover as well. Still battling for each and every ball and each and every point. A 22-point advantage. Nominal differential between shot and game clock at the end. What a performance from the Czech Republic.
Can't speak more highly of it, and they've made Brazil look second rate. They've picked them off at the offensive end, and down on defense made life really, really miserable for them. They're only shot it at 40% from the field. That's below their average, and a lot of credit goes to the Czech Republic and the defense that they've put in place. This is not just about a team having an off night shooting wise. This is a team that's run into a wall.
And the play stopped with 10.2 to play, a 24 point Czech Republic lead, led by the 20 of Satoransky, 15 for Balvin, who's got a double double, 12 for Bohacik, but so many others have stepped up beneath those three as well, 14 for Alder. Final seconds, Spenic, contested three, doesn't go, the tip for Felicio will. And they'll still try and get a few more. Brazil battered, bruised and embarrassed by red-hot Czech Republic. Brazil suffer their first win. And Czech Republic level up the records at 3-1 each as they beat Brazil by 22, 93-71.
Yeah, first loss of the tournament for Brazil. And in emphatic fashion did it come. Have a look at the numbers. They speak for themselves, really. Just a spectacular shooting performance by the Czech Republic. Not so great for Brazil. Again, the Czech Republic over, or 40% plus in the competition every game from the three-point line. And look at points in the paint too, 46 of them. So they found their way, and that was just through great ball movement, good passing. Satoransky, we sung his praises with his 20 points, but that doesn't tell the whole picture. And look at the Czech Republic team rejoicing. This is a momentous occasion for them.
And that is the word, isn't it? The Czech Republic team. They were very much a team, despite the superstar presence of Tomáš Satoransky. He shared the ball around for 9 assists, as well as his 20 points, 7 rebounds, 3 steals and 2 blocks. The standout stat line, but so many others as well getting involved. 15 for Balvin, who had 11 rebounds, 14 for Alder, 12 for Bo Hatchik. And they are loving it.
And the formula from now on is, if Greece lose to the United States, then they need to beat the Czechs by more than 13.
There's a lot of
message coming through.
Calculations and equations still to do here in Shenzhen at the 2019 FIBA World Cup. But the calculations for Czech Republic are simple. Just get it and shoot and pass it and move it. And it is taking them somewhere special into uncharted territory. This Czech Republic team, who are at their very first World Cup, and they are doing something very special.
Yeah, and with what we've seen throughout the tournament, and particularly here this afternoon, is it's not just about the win here, it's about their prospects moving forward. And you do not have to stretch your imagination too far, given the way that this team is playing, is that they can compete with France, they can compete with Australia. They can certainly cause some headaches for Serbia. So there's a lot going in their favour, not just with this win, but what lies ahead.
And against a couple of NBA bigs on the interior, an ex-NBA big in Varejao, they shot it at 64% from two-point range, Czech Republic. And we already knew how good their outside shooting was, coming in at 43.3%. From deep, it's a team that looks to be very together, but also has plenty of quality and a little bit of everything.
They do, and Balvin, he unsung hero in my mind. He picked up the 11 rebounds and 15 points, but as we spoke about throughout the course of the day, how teams guard on-ball screens goes a long way to setting the tone for your overall defense, and he does it really well. He uses his length well, he can slide his feet, keep people in front of him, and real intimidating around the basket. So they've got most bases covered, you would think, this Czech Republic team.
A 21-point loss to the US to start, but it is now a 3-game win streak at the World Cup for Czech Republic as they down Brazil by 22. Only the third time this century Brazil have lost by more than 20 points at the FIBA World Cup. You can see what it means for those Czech players who are absolutely loving the experience and thriving here on the grand stage. Here's a look at Group K. Czech Republic and Brazil tied at 3-1. The big one to come this evening, USA against Greece in a couple of hours. Do join us for that one here in Shenzhen. We'll see you there.